Hey YouTube, it's Scotty Man here, and welcome to yet another review in my ongoing Legendary Starship series. Today I'll be reviewing the Legendary Command Dreadnought Cruiser. It has a hull modifier of 1.4 and shield modifier of 1.25. Four fore weapons and four aft. For bridge officer stations, we get a Lieutenant Commander Tactical, Commander Engineering and Command Hybrid, Lieutenant Commander Science, Lieutenant Universal, and Ensign Universal. Four Tactical, four Engineering, and three Science consoles. Base turn rate of 6, impulse modifier of 0.14, inertia of 30, and plus 5 to all power levels. The ship can equip dual cannons and has a hangar bay filled with Type 8 shuttles. I ditched those ASAP. This ship has the most consoles of any ship in the pack, with a whopping number of 6. The first is from the original Operations Odyssey. Chevron Separation detaches the main chevron and has it fly into combat with you as a pet. This is much like the Saucer Separation console, in the sense that it's more of a gimmick than a viable option. The next comes from the Science Odyssey. Workbees launches 4 Workbees to repair your ship over a 10-second duration. Again, this is more of a gimmick now than useful. The last console from the original Tier 5 Odysseys came from the Tactical Odyssey. Aquarius Escort will launch the small craft at the back of your ship to assist you in battle. It's a bit more useful than the Chevron from my experience, but still, as I keep saying, a gimmick. If you decide to equip all 3 consoles, you'll get the Enhanced Engineering Systems set bonus. This gives plus 1 flight turn rate, 25% recharge time reduction to all Odyssey consoles, plus 12 energized hull plating, plus 12 ablative hull plating, plus 12 electroplasma flow, and gives the Chevron the ability to deploy its own workbees and Gravity Well 3. The Adaptive Emergency Systems console originally came from the Sojourner Operations Odyssey. It gives a passive bonus to all energy damage resistance as well as 3.3% maximum hull capacity. The clicky, when activated, gives you plus 50 to all damage bonus resistance, or 75 if your hull is 50% or less, as well as plus 30% bonus all damage, or 45% if hull is at 50% or less for 30 seconds. Seeing as the clicky provides Cat 2 damage for 30 seconds and has a potential to be 45%, this console is pretty darn good. Dampening Wave Emitter came from the Yorktown Science Odyssey. It gives a passive bonus of 15% to your maximum shield capacity. Upon using the clicky, a 4-kilometer wave of radiation will hit enemies dealing radiation damage over 15 seconds, as well as cutting all their energy damage down by 80% and disabling them for 5 seconds. The last console, Flagship Tactical Computer, came from the Endeavor Tactical Odyssey, and gives a passive bonus to energy damage. Upon using the Fleet Weapon Acceleration clicky, you'll be granted plus 50% flight speed strength, plus 50% turn rate strength, and plus 33% firing cycle haste to your energy weapons for 15 seconds. I find this console very useful and use it a lot on my alts. If you equip all 3 consoles, you get access to the Deadly Response set bonus. This gives 2% crit chance, plus 3 turn rate, and 10% chance when receiving damage while a shield facing is depleted to apply 1 stack of Deadly Response. This gives 2,500 temporary hull hit points, and plus 10% bonus all damage for 10 seconds. This can stack up to 3 times. Additionally, if you own the Timeline Stabilizer from the Krenim Science Vessel and equip it, you'll gain the Flagship Technology set bonus. This further improves all 3 consoles. Adaptive Emergency Systems will gain its bonus at 75% hull instead of 50%. Violent Dampening Wave will increase its radius to 5 km from 4 km, and Fleet Weapon Acceleration will increase its duration from 15 seconds to 20 seconds. We also get 4 traits after completing our Cruiser Mastery Package. The first trait is Adaptive Hull Plating. When using a hull heal or command buff ability, you gain plus 3% maximum hull hit points. This trait originally came from the Sojourner. The next trait came from the Yorktown. Checkmate gives 30% extra projectile weapon damage and exotic damage for 15 seconds when activating control buff abilities like Gravity Well. The last trait unlocked at Tier 5 is Supercharged Weapons, and originally came from the Endeavor. When firing a torpedo, you gain 1 stack of Supercharged. This gives you plus 10% damage, plus 10% critical chance, and plus 6.6 critical severity. This can stack up to 3 times. Continuing Mission is the new trait unlocked at Tier 6, and gives plus 5% maximum hull and up to 48% hull regen that scales based on missing hull to your entire team when your ship is affected by a command or fleet ability. Overall, the amount of value for investment with this ship is undeniable. 6 consoles and 4 traits is crazy. Coupled with the addition of a hangar and a command ship mechanic, it improves on the original and then some. I'm going to give the ship a 9 out of 10. I've always loved the Odyssey, and now I love it even more. Now I'll be going over Space Barbie stuff, so if that's not your thing, fair warning. The first skin is the Odyssey skin. followed by the Sojourner. The Yorktown. Endeavor. And finally, the Verity. There are also two unique bridges, the Aquarius and the Odyssey. Well, that's all for this video. I'm sorry it took an extra day to get out. There was just so much to unpack with this one. And with that, this is Gettyman, signing off. Have a good one.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. If you have any questions, compliments, or complaints, please put them in the comments below. And as always, take care out there.